gonna be straight. I just think they need to watch him because he got all the resources. Really, he has all the resources. He has all the pull. Man, I think he gonna. I don't know. I just don't think him and what's his name? Javi.
Slinging the guns for him.
Yeah, I don't trust that.
I don't trust him. I don't trust him at all because he already tried to get over on Franklin once, and he's a scammer. He's a hustler. He gonna do whatever. He one of those type of dude, whatever it take to save his neck. So he all about himself. And so whole situation where I think that's what's gonna kind of hurt. That's gonna hurt Franklin in the long run because that's his plug, and he's solely reliant on Reed, and he doesn't understand like once Reed kind of get shut down, it's pretty much over for his whole operation.
Whole operation. Done.
He completely reliant on him and his prices. And that's what his auntie would tell him, like, hey, look, if we have any raising prices, we're gonna get hurt because they don't have the streets as much as they had before, and they don't have the product that they had. You know what I'm saying? So she already tell him, like, look, if they raise the prices of anything happen, man, we're gonna be pretty much SOL because we're not in the position where we were before.
Yeah. They're gonna come after them.
Exactly. You can't feed them wolves. They're gonna come get you. And he's seeing that other product, that other people are bringing product in now, and plus other people know how to do the, they know how to cook it up. So you don't have the advantage anymore. Yes, you got probably the purest dope, but when you don't have that supply anymore, people are gonna be getting it from other places. And I think that's where it's gonna be whole situation. And I think he knows that, and I think that's why he came up with this crazy idea of being able to. Him sitting down. Like, what did you think was going to happen when he sat down with the team and they tried to make a decision over Scully and Manboy? How did you think that dynamic was going to work? Who they're going to side with before everything happened?
Man, I really honestly thought they was going to try to take Manboy out.
You did?
I would have took Manboy out because, like you said, Manboy, he's smart. Yep. He's smart. So I feel like it's easier to control Scully because you know what he's gonna do. He's crazy. He's crazy. So it's easier to control him. You know what he's gonna do. But Manboy, like I said, he's smart. He hungry. You know what I mean? And he's already showing you he really don't respect you. And he be playing with him, saying little slick shit. You know what I mean? Scully, he don't care about none of that. Just give me my dope. You know, go on about your way. Let me put my acid. Let me do my thing. But man, boy, he conniving, man. He conniving. Yeah. So I'd have took him out.
I thought it was gonna go the opposite way. I thought they were gonna go with Scully because I'm like I said, you got a wild boy. Sometimes you don't know what the wild boy is gonna do. You can't control him. Like I said, he putting drugs in his ear. He being a drug. You know what I'm saying? He's just doing wild stuff. So I thought they were gonna go him because I felt like he was the more vicious one. You know, he was the more one that was all about, hey, I put somebody in the ground. I'm gonna make it look vicious. I'm gonna make it look ugly. So I was like, oh, they'll probably go at him. And then you can kind of. Even though Manboy is ambitious and he's smart, but I feel like people like that, he can probably almost control a little bit more, you know, with the dope because he's solely relying on him as being a plug. So gotcha. I think he can be like, hey, look, if you don't, you know what I'm saying, you don't do what I want, I can raise the prices on you, or you know what I'm saying, I can short you and bleed you out and to make you doing what I want to do. But somebody like Manboy, Scully, he'll send a hitter at you, you know.
Yeah,
yeah, because he wild. And I think, you know what I'm saying, that's why I thought that, you know, in that moment they were like, man, who should we get? But the auntie, like I said, she was leaning towards what you were talking about, where, you know, he's smart, you know, he you know, so he's ambitious, he want to be his own guy, he want to be a king. He always talks sideways to Franklin,
always, bro. Even with Leon, remember Leon had to
talk sideways to Leon. But the reason why Franklin like him, because he got the blocks, he got the hustle, and he can go get it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So that was, and then for him to come up with this crazy idea to say, all right, man, I'm gonna basically set both of them up, and then we're gonna ambush them. Like, bro, you know that's not gonna work. Like, what are you doing?
It's not gonna work. Yeah, you got Manboy boy popping up in there with peaches, acting up, getting all antsy, itchy already. I'd have been like, nah, bro, he can't come. He can't come. And then, yep, it came and he blew the whole plan.
Yep, blew it up, got out there too early because the boy got out there talking about he's seeing roaches and he tripping, he high. You know, he talking about he gonna use it so he can stay focused, but that saved his life though, if you think about it. You know what I'm saying? Yep. like, because if had he got all the way into the warehouse, they were gonna be dumping them slugs in the car, and he was gonna get in the got.
Car. Yeah, car, man.
They gonna get them slugs in the car. And I knew he wasn't dead, and because you know what I'm saying, when even when Man Boy said, "Oh, I shot him," but I was like, "Man, they're gonna be too easy for him to just die like that, because that'll kind of kill the whole story too fast." I'm like, he lived somehow, and plus they didn't get the body, so I knew it was gonna be somehow he got back. But you know, on another note, like when you see this reported new aspect where this reporter is going, you know, trying to track down things and trying to figure out what happened to Mel's daddy, to see how Mel did a whole, you know, saying 180, where she's all holy rolling now. You know what I mean? Right. What did you think about when you saw that?
Man, I was thinking about that. I'm like, man, when they gonna bring in Mel? When they gonna bring in Mel? Because they talking about when Franklin got shot by Mel. You know, they steady seeing them limping around. So, man, I did not see Mel being strictly, but something's off. Something's off with her. But she's like strictly just like
holy roly. She all
holy
hurt.
Yeah.
Clean that, and I think that's where her auntie kind of got into her to kind of help, you know, straighten her out a little bit, because she was probably a cracked out fiend when she when her dad died. She was a cracked out fiend, and now all of a sudden, you know what I'm saying, she all about the word, she with the Bible, you know, she's all about this. So she found her, I guess she found her purpose, or somebody kind of, you know, feed it to her, because she feels weird, feels like not, it doesn't feel real.
Like she a robot or something. Like she's just like it's.
Yeah.
It's like she's programmed to say those type of things. Like
exactly.
She's not really meaning what she's saying, but like she's just saying it. Like because, like I said, she's programmed. Like it's programmed to say that type of stuff, man. But I feel like what they said that she's in Odessa, right? It said Odessa, so that's Texas, right?
Yeah, and that you know, she's always talked about, even when her dad was there, they were talking about, you know, her going to stay with her aunt, moving to her aunt, or going to visit her aunt. You know.
Yeah.
Yeah, when they was talking, when he was alive, talking about taking a trip and going to visit the aunt and stuff like that. So before she,
I think she's gonna come back to LA, man. So I think she's gonna have to come back. Somehow she gonna end up back in LA, messing with Franklin or.
Yeah, I think she's gonna, because they wouldn't have showed her. They probably just had to show her, you know what I'm saying, to kind of write off the show, but I doubt if they're gonna write off the show this fast. So, you know, I'm hoping that she get back in there and they kind of figure out a way to kind of explore her role and expand her role a little bit more. And I think that'll be good for the show as well, because it'll show that dynamic with Franklin and kind of get him off his P's and Q's, because when she around, you know, that's his little sweetheart. Yeah. Back in the day, he kind of like, you know, he kind of move a little different when she in the city and she moving around. But I don't know how it's gonna be after she put them slugs in him, and he knows she put them in him. You know what I'm saying? She put those in him. She tried to kill him, bro. Shot him in. Tried to kill him, bro.
Still stood over the top of him.
Put it over top of him. Put them bullets in him. She tried to kill him.
Tried to kill him. You know what's crazy? What you think about the new girl?
The new girl that know
he stayed over.
Know about the hood, that know about the hood.
Yeah. You know, I don't trust her either, man. She about to.
Yeah, she's all for self too. You know what I'm saying? She all about the paper, and she all about, I feel like she'll set him up if she get the opportunity to. So she just felt a little weird little vibe from it. I felt a weird little vibe from when I saw her. So we'll see how that play out. I think this news reporter is going to be trouble for them. Because, with her, I think she's gonna be trouble, because you know what I'm saying, she felt like, I grew up in this neighborhood, I see this neighborhood changing, I want to know why, I want to dig into it, and I think that's gonna be a big problem for them.
She's starting to put the pieces together.
She gonna
her, and her sidekick, the little young brother, they starting to put the pieces together.
Yeah, it's gonna take a little while, but they're gonna continue to put it together. And just to go kind of go back a little bit, take a step back, before they went to the ambush, you know, his pops, you know, Franklin pops, he always knows, you know, he knows how Franklin moves and he knows what's going on. And you can tell he knows what's going on the way he talked to Franklin. He's like, "Oh, you finna head out? You got the 45?
Yeah.
The 45 with you. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So he's trying to like, "Hey, let's pop in. Let's pop in one of the old kung fu movies, get some popcorn. Let's just chill tonight." And he can feel, I think he can just sense that when something bad about to happen. I think he can just sense it when something about to happen bad. And so he tries to stop Franklin in his own way. And then just to see how Franklin interact with him in that moment, to give him an embrace him in a hug, like almost like, "This guy almost can be my last time hugging you or seeing you," and kind of embrace him in that way.
Right. Yeah. Right. Yeah, his pops, like you said, his pops can his pop see like, man, he's slipping. He's slipping. Like, it's too much. He got shot, and his pop's like, look, you know, like, you got lucky. You got shot. Like, man, and like I say, he sees all the killings, and the mom came home with the paper about, you know, I mean, but the hug was before, but he knew. He leaving at what? Late at night?
Yeah, he know what's going down. He know something. Yeah. You know what I mean? They try to stay out of it, but of course they're involved in it, but they try to stay out of the day-to-day, you know what I'm saying, the nitty-gritty side of it. You know what I'm saying? Mom and pop try to get the gritty side of it, but they know what's going on. They know he out there in the streets. They know it's dangerous. He in the drug game, and it's going to be a lot of death come with it, because they've been seeing these bodies dropping. It's on the news, and they're kind of like fearful for him, because at the same time, that's the dynamic that kind of broke up, you know, him and his mom and her brother, you know, with Jerome. You know what I'm saying? Just seeing them two kind of have that dynamic, you know, break up when Franklin got shot. He want to get Franklin back in the game, but she like, no, he need to rest. He need to, you know what I'm saying, heal up. Yeah. And now they kind of fractured that whole relationship, and you can just see the tension on the show between the family now. You know what I'm saying? You can just see all that's happening, unraveling from him just getting shot and not being, you know, being able to take care of himself.
Yeah. Yep. That's the thing. Yep. Unraveling. And man, you know, after he got shot, you know, like I say, he laid low. He don't know what to do. He don't know how to stop. He don't know how to stop all the killings. He don't know how to stop all, you know, he see his people, just all that stuff, all the drug addicts, all the other stuff, all because of him. It's starting to take effect, man.
He really thought he was just going to be able to sling that dope, get the money, and not see the effects of it, you know, immediately happening to his community, where, bro, it's hitting home. Your girlfriend, she got cracked out. Your best friend, his girlfriend got cracked out. And now you're just seeing how, you know what I'm saying, you're going to that, like in season two, I think he went into the dope fiend house to go get mail out. He was seeing how the crack house was looking. So it's kind of opening his eyes, because, like I said, he was supposed to go to some of this prep school, so he didn't really see none of this. And when he went and to learn how to cook up, he didn't really see like the other side of what was happening up in Oakland when the crack was out in the streets. He just learned how to cook, went back to LA, started cooking up, and then all of a sudden you start making his money, but then, you know, you don't see the immediate
everything that come with it.
And he was talking about that, like, you know, he didn't know how this going to affect his neighborhood. And, you know, now they're making so much money that you can't stop now. You know what I'm saying? You got so many people relying on you. And what he's supplying, and think about it, he's supplying both sides. He's supplying Scully and he's supplying Man Boy. And them boys are the two biggest players in the city. So what do? You just try to squash it. And then, like, if it don't work, all right, man, we got to see if I can get these guys replaced. But he's not fully immersed in the street life yet, so I think that's gonna be his challenge to try to figure. I think he gotta get Leon back on the squad, because
you see he called him. He hit Leon up, because he know, he like, man, I need this boy Leon. I need Leon to do what he do.
So he try to get Leon to hear his up, let him know, man, you know, something went down, went left. You know, them guys might be out for y'all, so keep your head squared up. So, man, to wrap this up, let you go ahead and give you your last piece, and then we'll wrap it up about your first episode and what you think about, you know what I'm saying, overall for the first episode, coming back in without John Singleton and his hand totally directly on this episode, on this season.
Yeah, man. So the first show, I think it was good, man. I think it was good how it came back on, and it slowly, you know, showed Franklin slowly trying to get back in the game. Well, he's been gone, but it also showed that since he's been down, how quickly that crack just took a hold of the community. So, man, I think it was a damn good first episode, man. A damn good first episode. Just like I said, just letting the viewers look, you know, grabbing the viewers, you know, because it's been off air for a minute. So, man, when it came back on, you know, it was excited, and I definitely think this first episode really lived up to the hype. Really lived up to the hype, man. Even explaining everything that was going on, where they at, the new route with the new, like I said, with the new police chief in Mexico. Then at I think that was in the second show, but man, when they went to Louis New Year's Eve party, mm-hmm. Leon was with Gustavo, man, I think that's gonna come into play too. But yeah, so I think his first episode was real good. I think it was really good.
Me too.